Hi everyone, welcome back to the Astro Room, your very own portal to the cosmos. And the Astro Room is here giving you more knowledge, more tips, more tricks, more education on the Seestar S50. And I will be revealing more secrets in this video. If you wondered how can you get more of the latest news and updates about the Seestar on social media or any other resources or websites where you can learn more about them, stay tuned because you're in for a surprise. And for those of you who have not purchased a Seestar just yet, but are thinking about it, or you recently purchased one, but you haven't received your order, stay tuned till the end of this video because we will get to that too. Okay, let's jump in everyone. All right, so I'm here on the actual Seestar official website of the Seestar at seestar.com. And you will notice that on their homepage, if you scroll all the way down to the end, all the way down, okay, they reveal their social media. And this is important because anytime you want updates on the Seestar or regarding the Seestar, you're going to want to come here. You're going to want to bookmark these sites. You will want to remember these sites so you can refer to them. We're going to go over them one by one and see what it is, see what the Seestar is posting, see what they're talking about, and see what they want the Seestar community to know, which is all of us. So let's go one by one. Let's look at their YouTube channel. I have it pulled up already right here. And if you notice, they already have a few videos on here. They have some tutorials on how to use the Seestar. They have on video on what do you get in the box when you purchase one. So you want to subscribe and you're going to click on that right there, the @Seestar_Astro. Okay. You want to make sure you follow them, right? In case they start putting more videos regarding the Seestar soon. Now, they also have a Twitter account. And stay with me here. You're going to see some very interesting things as we keep going along. Now, their Twitter account has some really cool astrophotography from others, from the community on here that you can check out. And following them on Twitter can inspire you to do some of these as your next object. They have some even comets on here. Okay, look at that. That's awesome. And you're going to notice, and I'll talk about it, but there's a theme that keeps reoccurring on all of their social media pages. And that's important for a reason I'm about to show you. But first, let's go to their Instagram. Now, you want to make sure you follow them on all of these social media sites that they have, okay? Here we have the Seestar.official on Instagram, okay? If you're an Instagram person, check them out here. They already have over 1,000 followers. It's pretty important to follow them on social media because they will actually post as soon as there's an update or a firmware update, okay? They actually posted and they talked about it. So, you know, sometimes we don't realize there's been an update, right? We forget, we don't notice, and you know, you might miss out. It's probably been out for a few hours or days and we don't even know about it. Well, you know, whether it's their Twitter or Instagram, they're posting about it. They're all over that. So you see here when there was an update before that, they talked about it immediately. They posted it. We have an update on the firmware here, so check it out. You definitely want to see what they're talking about and see what's interesting, these things they have to let us know. Now, this is what I wanted to show everyone, something else before we get to their Facebook page. Stay with me here. This is really interesting. A lot of people don't realize these things. Sometimes, like I said in my other video, we get distracted with doing stuff and we start imaging and all of a sudden we start having all these questions, but we forget to look them up or we don't know where to find them. Well, in particular with the Seestar website, okay, they have a lot of FAQ, a lot of questions with the answers already there that you've probably wondered about. There's some really, really good questions on here. And this I really like here. Some of you might be thinking about the solar eclipse. You might be traveling to your destination to go to the path of totality for this eclipse that's upcoming in April, right? And you're wondering, how do I travel with the Seestar? How do I do it safely? How do I make sure my Seestar arrives all intact with me if I'm traveling on a plane? So let's check it out. They have the answer here. Can the Seestar S50 be transported by air with a battery in it? Yes. What it is saying here, it says that their battery is compliant with the standards set by the Civil Aviation Administration for air transportation. Based on their experience, it can be carried in the luggage. However, if you plan to check it in as a baggage, some airlines may require the battery to be removed from the device. So they recommend you check with a specific airline, right? Now, I'll be honest with you, if I'm traveling, this is me personally, or the Astro Room team is traveling with the Seestar, I will most likely not check it in. That's just me. I don't feel comfortable checking it in. It says here you can, but personally, I'm just not going to do that. I'm going to take it with me instead as like a little carry-on. Yeah, because I just want to see it with me at all times, so to speak. Make sure it's safe, you know, if I'm getting on a plane. That's just what I'm going to do. Now, another question here is it waterproof? It's not waterproof, everyone. The Seestar, if the weather is changing, if it starts raining, make sure you put it up, store it. Don't leave it out there, okay? Another question here is, what is the wind protection level of the Seestar for outdoor use? Of course, it says yes, you can use it when it's windy, and most of us do probably use it when it's a little windy out there, but it says here they recommend using it when the wind chill is 4 and below. So just something to keep in mind, because obviously, right, when it's too windy, it's going to affect the quality of your image, it's going to start discarding more images, right, the tracking accuracy and all of that. Now, another question here is, how long does the Seestar take to fully charge? This is under the section batteries and supplies. It says 4 hours on a normal charging mode and 2 hours on a fast charging mode. And I'm thinking this is when the battery is fully depleted and you have to charge from scratch, right, from the beginning. Now, I don't think I've used a full charge just yet. So normally, I think I've used maybe like up to half of, or so of the battery. And then it takes about maybe, I want to say 2 or 3 hours for it to fully charge back up again. Another one here is, how long is the battery capacity and battery life of the Seestar? 6 hours is typical use, right? Of course, keeping in mind that the less you use your dew shield, the less the power consumption. But you know, sometimes we just have to use the dew shield, right? It is what it is, and that's okay. Just know that, of course, like your battery will just consume more, right? The Seestar might not last as long. And here we go now. So what is the battery life of the Seestar and how to replace it? So this is a whole other question from the one we just did. It says that the Seestar battery is capable of over 700 charges and discharge cycles. Now stay with me here. This is going to get really interesting. It says additionally, the warranty, this is important to know, the warranty here, you've got warranty since the date of purchase, and it says you should, or should you, excuse me, require a battery replacement, please visit our official website for a seamless replacement process. So visit the official Seestar website. That's nice, guys. So this warranty is from 1 year, right? From the date of purchase is my understanding here. And this is wonderful, everyone. Now you might be wondering what happens when the battery is just done, right? Like it's dead completely. It's just failing completely. For future reference, okay, something to keep in mind, just like with any other device, like for instance, your phone, your tablets, right? After a long time, after many years of use, the battery life overall decreases over time, right? The battery over time, it gets weak because you're charging it over and over again, day in, day out, night after night. So you notice that the battery starts draining a little bit more quickly, right? That's why you have to upgrade your phone. People buy a new phone every year or so, every 3 or 5 years, right? Now, with the Seestar, please know everyone that you are able to open the scope and take out the battery and completely replace it with a brand new one. Once it gets to that depleted state, right, weak battery state, and you know you will need a new one, once you start noticing that the battery cannot hold the charge as long as before, now, no need to go and do this now. Most of us have not even had the scope for a year. So I'm talking about way in the future, right? Like years from now, right? When you see that the battery life is just not as good as it was. And everyone, please don't attempt this. If you have no idea what you're doing, I'm warning you right now, okay? Don't try to even open it right now or open your scope. Try to see how it's done. How's the battery in there, okay? Trust me on this. If you don't know what you're doing, don't mess up your device, okay? Don't try and take out that battery right now just for fun or to take a peek, okay? Don't do that. You want to treat it with care, right? But just know that you can replace the full battery. You can take out the old battery when it gets to that point and put a brand new one in. That could probably be now for a future video, or we can get into how to do that and stuff. So yeah, the battery of the Seestar is replaceable. You can basically make it brand new again. It's like you've gotten a whole new smart telescope, right? A whole new Seestar. And just basically, it's like the charge cycles restart again, right, with a new battery. So this is why I'm telling all of you, it's so important to check out their website. For those of you that have stayed watching this video up to this point, just wait and see. There's a lot more stuff here coming up, and this is good. Thank you for staying. There's so much to learn here. Look at all their social media. Read everything you can. Educate yourself. And you know the Astro Room is always here for you, giving you all of this. So continue to stay tuned because I want to make sure all of you are well-versed on the latest and the greatest from the Seestar. Okay, so this is what I wanted to get to for some of you who have just purchased your Seestar or are still waiting for your order or thinking about purchasing one. If you have already purchased and you have not received the order and you're wondering where your order is. Now, once again, this is why it's so important to follow them on all their social media, right? I'm on their Facebook page right now. If we go back, I can show you guys here. I clicked on their Facebook page, and this is what comes up. Look at what they are posting. As I was saying, there is a reoccurring theme on all of their social media sites as of February 2024. It's this spring festival. Basically, they are talking about their Lunar New Year. Remember, this is a Chinese company, right? So, and this is a normal practice in Asia, not just particular to this company, not just ZWO, which is the maker of the Seestar, but pretty much all companies or businesses in Asia. What they do is they shut down operations of their companies throughout the time that they are celebrating the Lunar New Year. And it says it right here. Look, they just posted it like 5 days ago, very recently. It says, "Dear valued customers, as we usher in the Lunar New Year," basically the Chinese New Year, "we want to keep you informed about our schedule from February 4th to the 18th of 2024. We will temporarily pause shipments. Additionally, our services will be on a brief hiatus from February 8th through the 18th. During this period, responses to messages and inquiries may experience slight delays. And then, you know, we appreciate your understanding. Shipping operations will resume on February 19th. So yeah, it's holiday time for them, everyone. So just keep that in mind. If you just recently ordered, you haven't gotten it yet, you're waiting, this is the reason why. I know it's hard to wait. Just be a little patient. It's coming for you. It's coming. They will ship it out as soon as they can, okay? And remember, this specifically applies to you if you have purchased from the Seestar website themselves, okay? If you have purchased this from a third party, in other words, if you have not purchased this from ZWO directly or the Seestar website, like I said, then it may not apply to you. There may not be a delay. So those of you that have not yet purchased or thinking about it, you know, just keep this in mind. So looking at their Facebook page here now, once again, they are posting regularly. You see, 2 days ago, they talked about the newest firmware version. And this is the other update that we've had way more recently, right? The mini one they did. I love this. They just talk about it here again, just letting you know that there has been an update. You know, make sure you download it. I thought this was interesting. They have there was a European Astro Fest in London for all of you out there in Europe. Take a look at this. This is really neat. This was recent. It's a 2-day event. And ZWO was there, right? The maker of the Seestar. And they posted pictures of them at the event. Obviously, they are promoting the Seestar here. Maybe all of you already know, but these guys do. This company does make a lot more other products for astrophotography, for telescopes, cameras, right? This company has been around for a long time. They have great quality products that the majority, if not almost all, professional and amateur astrophotographers use. Their products and their telescopes and on their imaging, right? Very reputable company, everyone. So good track record. So yeah, they are all in. Anyway, this is when I wanted to show everyone. Check out the video here from the London Astro Fest. I wish I could have been there, man. It looks awesome. And yeah, on Facebook, they give other tips and other advice, little videos from professionals or other astrophotographers. It's really good. So check it out, everyone. Go to the Seestar website. Go to seestar.com and then go to the end of the page and you will see at the bottom all their social media links once again, okay? Go ahead and look. Boom, boom, boom. Follow them. bookmark these sites so you can be up to date. I can't emphasize enough to follow them on social media. Thank you again, everyone, for tuning in, and stay here on the Astro channel, your very best for all things space, all things smart telescope, and more. I'm your portal here to the cosmos. Make sure you hit the like. Make sure you show your support, please. I appreciate it so much if you subscribe. This helps the channel grow, continue growing, and it helps also the Astro Room continue making more content and better content for all of you. And let me know in the comments what you think about all these tips and updates that I'm posting, okay? For all of you. Thank you so much.